You ought to be banned. You ought to be server banned.
Yep. It's time to talk about Dafty Boy again. Today's show is brought to you by channel members and patrons alike. To contribute to this show, hit that join button or head over to www.patreon.com/theplothole1. That's the number one, not the loneliest number you can ever do. Rack Focus. Hey everyone, Johnny O from the Plot Hole. Today I have a small collection of what I like to call frutas poopas. You all know what to do, so grab your Charmin Ultra Strong and let's get to wiping. Now, this first video we have the best of humanity and the worst of humanity. Check it out. And people say the post office is terrible. No idea what was wrong with that first delivery driver, but for some reason she had to take it out on these curtain rods? How the hell am I supposed to know what it is? The second delivery person could have just dropped his package, but no. He decided to do a nice thing for someone he doesn't know, which is something that we could all strive to do. You know, do something nice for somebody tomorrow, today, you know, once a day, be nice to somebody. You never know what could happen. Anyway, next. Well, 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 if it isn't my favorite Karen. The angry shopping Karen. Karen here seems to be in some sort of fruit store. Apparently, she didn't think the fruit was ripe for the picking. Great googity muggity, somebody's angry. She's probably
fuming! Mega, mega fuming!
Yeah, what that lady said. I mean, I guess they should have had that purple telephone she wanted. Look, Karen, I get they couldn't get you back into your iCloud, but that's probably because you couldn't remember your password. Write that shit down next time. I'm going to say, Hey, Karen, I think you might have missed one in that whole store.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Are you enjoying the show? Of course you are. Then why haven't you clicked that like button? Go on, click it. Have you subscribed? No? Well, what are you waiting for? Be sure to tickle that bell, too. That way you get notified every time a new video comes out. While you're here, check out all the membership options. The merch store, PayPal links, all that is in the description box. Can't afford any of that? That's okay. A simple like, share, and subscribe is all the support I need. And it's greatly appreciated. Remember, if you build it, they will come. Now, this next video comes courtesy of our favorite crusader of the crazy, I guess, Tom Rabbit, in his, in his quest to document the phenomenon known as Daft Dawkins. I usually don't comment on another video, but seeing as how Daft said my name a few times, I figured what the hell.
My whole point is these people are phonies. Every single one of them.
We agree on that. Listen, you know the plot hole?
I know the plot hole.
I told you that. They invited me to have a debate about the
age. No. Don't even, listen to me. Don't even go on there. The both of them have the mentalities and disposition of obnoxious teenagers and they're grown adults.
The both of them? And who would that be there, Daft Man?
So I would not go on their show. J.L. Warren has publicly slandered and defamed me. He has been confronted in writing on Discord and verbally, and he has doubled down on his slander of me. They've also done repeated attacks upon me. Johnny O at the Plot Hole recently did a bizarre psychotic rant against me. You can watch it yourself. It was like a 15-year-old did it.
A bizarre rant? I mean, I thought it was amusing. And I also thought my impersonation was spot on.
Okay. If you're going to go on an atheist show, at least go on a show that doesn't engage in public slander and defamation of a fellow Christian and atheists who don't behave like absolute imbeciles.
Let me assure you, Otangelo, you're not coming on to an atheist show full of imbeciles. I'm not an atheist.
The thing is that when they proposed first debate the age of the earth, then I asked him, is my interlocutor an atheist because of the age of the earth? And he said no. And then I said, well, then I see no reason to debate the age of the earth because I want to have debates with people which are atheists. And then he proposed me to have a debate about theism against atheism. I said, okay, we can have that. And then I had an interaction with Jill Warren and he was constantly over-talking me and then I left the room. And then yesterday I did find out that actually my debate partner on Thursday will be Jill Warren. They said, okay, I will debate you, but if it is a moderated debate where I have my time to actually answer to you. They agreed.
That's kind of what happened. As you all know, I don't do free-for-all debates. Every debate that I've had on the show has been moderated. And Otangelo, yes, when you come on as a guest on my show, you will be afforded the exact same treatment as I do everyone else who comes on the show. You will be treated with respect and given opportunity to get your points and speak your mind.
Oh, you see, that is precisely what I am saying. He is giving me motivation to actually dive into these arguments and then refute them. If you see, Yahweh is I am, and I am is absolutely fantastic description of God because it comes in the Old Testament over 6,000 times, and it means I am. He is the eternal. He has never...
Hey, Otangelo, how would you feel it if there was some moron atheist who had a stupid YouTube channel almost nobody knows about, came out and publicly slandered and defamed you, was confronted about it, was defiant about it, unrepentant about it, okay? They publicly slandered and defamed you, okay? And then your other fellow Christians that you interact with are just gonna go on and give them the right hand of fellowship in a debate, okay? How would you like that?
I mean, you are not alone. I mean, I've been slandered at Speed's channel
No, I'm talking about, listen, I'm not just talking about somebody criticizing and ridicule you. We're talking about public slander about one's personal life, okay? Now, do you remember what you wrote at Sidney Winston's channel?
Have you seen my replies there? I've replied.
Right, and do you know that JL Warren has done a very similar type of slander against me? Yet you're going on and treating him, you know, like he's just a regular typical atheist.
Perhaps that's because Otangela has more scruples than Darth. And as for what Darth says about JL, that's for JL to defend.
Okay, first of all, I didn't know this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm knowing it by you right now. I've committed to have this debate. I will not retract it. But I will consider what you are saying.
I mean, that's a
JL Warren is somebody like who is a vicious. Mm-hmm. He's a vicious, stupid YouTube atheist. He thinks he's smart. He's not. Okay? And he's somebody who has publicly engaged in slander and defamation against me. Okay? And he's been confronted about it. And he is defiant about apologizing for it. And he doubles and triples down on it. This is the kind of guy who claims that when I ask him, oh, where'd you get this information from? I said, because it's false. And he goes, journalistic privilege. He claimed he was a journalist. This is the kind of psycho that we're dealing with, okay?
Psycho in the colloquial definition? Because I think that makes you the pot calling the kettle here.
So you want to go on and debate somebody who you already know has publicly slandered into fame a fellow brother in the faith? Go ahead, Otangelo, then I won't have respect for you, okay? No different between you going on and debating with Sidney Winston, okay?
That's up to you, Darth. I mean, I deny to have a debate in regards of the age of the Earth. I felt already because he disrespected me in a conversation, constantly over talking me, and I left the room. So when I knew that it was him, I demanded that it would be a moderated debate. So I know about the territory that I am walking to. If I renounce or deny,
hot air is coming out of your mouth. Okay, you're just making one excuse after another. Okay. I told him out of respect for a fellow Christian, you should not debate this scumbag, okay? He's a pig.
I'll never understand why these folks keep going back to Darth. I mean, when he doesn't have an atheist to debate, he turns on his theist friends, I guess you could call them, and treats them as if they're some sort of servants to Darth. Like if they do something that he doesn't want or they can't step out of line or God forbid they have an opinion that's a little bit different than his. Why do you guys subject yourselves to that?
Well, if he, come on, Darth, man. If he, like, had a prior commitment and he didn't know all this stuff, would you want to back out now all of a sudden just because he found out about this?
Listen, when you publicly retract your slander and your defamation against Darth Dawkins about stuff in his personal life, which Darth has publicly repeated is categorically false, say, good, then I'll talk with you.
Well, class, what did we learn today? Dafty can't fight his own battles? Dafty has to have Otangelo to White Knight for him? Maybe if Darth truly feels that he's been slandered by JL Warren, then he'll take JL Warren to court. Don't worry, JL. I wouldn't expect to see any summons to appear anytime soon. Not to mention his mommy won't let him go out and play with the mean boys. I have to hand it to Otangelo for sticking to his guns and standing up to Darth Dawkins in this. I mean, it takes a lot of courage to stand up to the classroom bully. That being said, here's to today's dingleberries. And there you have it. I hope you brought some industrial grade soap to wash off all that filth. Got a little dirty today. Quick debate update. I've got three good ones on the schedule. This coming up Saturday, that's June 26th at 8:30 Central. That's 8:30 p.m. Central. We've got Nerd Angle versus Rob from Rob's World as they take on Loki's gender fluidity. Should be a lot of fun. Next Thursday, that's July 1st, we'll have the rescheduled debate between Otangelo and JL Warren, atheism versus theism, 8:30 again Central, 8:30 p.m. Central. I'm so looking forward to that one because it's one of my favorite topics to discuss. And then July 11th, I've got the amazing Crafty Keela debating Rob, once again from Rob's World, on the always controversial subject of abortion. Be sure to tune in for all three of those debates, and to keep up with the schedule, join that Discord room. Anyway, as always, I'm Johnny O, and I think you know what's coming. Finger guns, baby.